The speeds I almost always use on this drill press is the 500 RPM and the 1500 RPM. But switching between those two speeds means swapping the belts up and down, and that's actually pretty awkward.
Now on my homemade mill drill contraption, this combination of pulleys gives me about 1350 RPM, and that's actually a pretty good speed for drilling with a small drill. But if I'm drilling with a big Forstner bit like this, that just makes the chips fly all over the place. So a 550 RPM speed would be nice to have. So I'd like some step pulleys to go on here to give me this speed plus the 550 RPM. So I worked out with the same length belt, 78mm on here and 166 on here would give me that speed. But there's no step pulley that gives me those two sizes. This one is fairly close, but if I put that on here, that's too far up for a step pulley on here because I don't have a lot of vertical room. And even if I flip this pulley upside down to put the hub on the bottom, it'd be close enough, but there's no room for the hub below that. So I'm just gonna make a wooden pulley to go on here to give me that size. And that fits quite nicely on the hub of that pulley. Now I just need a V-groove in here, and I think I'll do that on my metal lathe. And I'm just doing the bevel on the side of that pulley freehand by turning both cranks at the same time. So this pulley fits on here nicely, but it goes down a little bit too far. So I made a shim to glue against it, like this. And here's my larger pulley blank for on here, but this is too big to turn on the metal lathe. So I got the spindle block on the workbench and the motor so I can turn that down wood lathe style. Now I'm just going to glue those two pulleys together to make a step pulley. And I'm going to take that off again before the glue sets too much because I'm afraid I might glue it to the shaft.
Uh-oh.
The glue on this piece is dry by now. Now I just need to drill a hole so I have access to the set screw. And I'm drilling that at a slight angle just so that my hole doesn't hit the bevels of the pulley as much. And a few blocks of wood on there so that the wooden pulley can't spin independently.
Uh-oh. Whoops.
I accidentally drilled one of my screw holes through the set screw hole. That's no good, so I gotta move it. My speed changes would be more elegant if it didn't take so long to release that belt tension and tension it up again. And at 500 RPM, those chips don't fly quite as far. The knob for belt tensioning is way back here and it takes a lot of turns, so that is really awkward. So I want to move this belt tensioning thing from the back here to the front, but that means taking this whole machine apart again. The way this now works is the threaded rod just goes through here, and I have a nut on here that I can just turn with my fingers like this, but I can't get a whole lot of force that way, but that's okay because all the tension I ever need for the V-belt I can get just by pushing on here, because with these large pulleys I really don't want a lot of tension. Now, I like about this machine that the table always stays at this height, not like a drill press table, but height adjustments are quite awkward. I have to pull out this pin and then crank this up, and that could be made a little bit easier. So I put a little handle on this pin and moved the hole closer, and I also added this nail here, which catches it so I don't have to hold it while I'm making the adjustment. But I also figure if this handle was a little bit shorter and tighter on here, I could just leave it on here. So I already cut it blank out of plywood, now I just need a square hole in it. And what a perfect excuse that is to use my machine. And after I made it, I had the idea of putting a magnet in there because I don't actually need it to be permanently attached. I just need it to not fall off and be short enough to never hit the table. So this wrench is far from the only wooden wrench I've made for this machine. There's also this one, which is a wooden collet wrench, which turns out to be not quite strong enough. But then I realized I could just grind open one of my router wrenches to use as a collet wrench, but by that time I'd already ordered this one, which is a proper collet wrench, and I also made this wrench to hold this part here against the force of this wrench, except this one turns out to be too short. It was meant to go with this one here, so I just made a longer one, which actually allows me to apply lots of torque on here, so this one is quite adequate. And I also made this wrench, which is also a modified router wrench, and that undoes this nut here, because for different speeds other than these two, I still need to change the pulley here. And then also this funny wrench, which is for tightening up the wing nuts here for locking the table, especially for the wing nut that's down here, because that one is hard to reach. I also seriously considered making a guard to go on here. I even tapped some holes in here for it to attach, but it has to be offset a fair bit so I can still get the belt in and out of the pulley. And it just looks bulky and it ruins the look of the machine, so I'll wait until I bump my head against this thing while it's running and hurt myself before I make this guard. So even though I meant this machine to be usable for milling metal, I don't think I have the machinist mindset, because in terms of tooling for it, I just make it out of wood when I need something because it's so much faster. And watching videos by machinists like Blondie Hacks or This Old Tony or Past Makes, when they make something out of metal from scratch, it just takes forever. So I figure my metalworking for this will probably be limited to drilling precise holes and milling something just to modify something, but never making something out of metal from scratch.